Welcome to those here and welcome to those watching online. It's great to have you with us, and a special greeting of Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers and mother figures out there, both here and in person. Let's give them a hand. Please take note of the, I redesigned the bulletin again. As far as announcements go, there's faith hands on the 20th, and volunteers or help is always appreciated, right, Becky? That'll be, what time should they be here if they want to help? 9:30 on Saturday, if you are willing to help. And Tabitha's Closet will be open that day. Help's always appreciated there, as well as the Necessities Closet will be open as well. And then the Saturday after that, the 27th, will be our, we're gonna have a fundraiser breakfast, and we'll need volunteers for that as well. And what time should they be here for that?
8:30.
On Saturday the 27th. And then also our annual golf tournament will be coming up on June 24th, and volunteers, donations will be needed for that day. And then also we're looking for a qualified nursery attendant for during Sunday morning worship. And if you know of anyone who would be interested, please come see me for details. And this will be a paid position, so we're looking for somebody who's worked with kids, who's certified, qualified. If you know of anybody, please let me know. We'll have some more information coming out about that as well. Then if you look at the back of your bulletin, Fellowship Christian Men, New Martinsville on Tuesday at 6 at Quinette's. Food pantry at Friendly will be open from 9 to noon on Thursday the 18th. And then we will have our Sunday evening worship tonight at 6 down in our chapel downstairs. And then Bible study at 6 on Thursday here, and then at Friendly on Wednesday at 6. And for those who weren't here on Thursday, we talked about spiritual gifts, and I left back there, straight back, on that table, there are spiritual gift surveys. They're not very long, and I would just encourage you, even if you aren't able to come to the Bible study, to still look at it and fill it out honestly, because you may learn something, God may reveal something to you about yourself that you didn't realize. So those are our straight back. And then you can also see that we're collecting still for, of course, for the shoe boxes. Gary, do you have anything you want to say about that?
Stuff for kids age 10 to 14. There's a poster on the way out.
Okay, poster on the way out for kids 10 to 14. We're looking for items. And then, of course, our offering boxes are straight back, and then one by the elevator as well. And am I missing any announcements? I think I pretty much got them all covered. Well, if there's no other announcements, then let us open with prayer, opening prayer followed by the Lord's Prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, as we gather here for worship this morning, Lord, open our hearts to receive your word and your will for our lives. Lord, help us to block out the distractions that keep us from fully experiencing your love and your presence, Lord. And Lord, guide us and direct us towards your purpose for our lives. Lord, we thank you for bringing us all here together in person and online, Lord, to worship. And Lord, we just praise you for your many blessings. And now we pray as you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And I would invite you to stand if you're able, and we will recite our call to worship. Live in God's love. Bring hope and peace to all whom you meet.
We are called to be God's witnesses.
Celebrate and rejoice.
Praise be to God who has called, healed, and given us the ministry of peace.
Amen. And you may be seated, because before we have the praise team come up, with it being a day that we honor mothers and mother figures, I wanted to share. I first read this a couple years ago, and it really spoke to me. I'm not going to read all of this, but it's called Like a Phone Call Home, John Wesley's Letters to His Mom. To those of you who don't know, John Wesley is the one who started the movement that later became known as Methodism. And John's brother Charles was a prolific hymn writer. He wrote thousands of hymns over the years. And the profound impact that Susanna, that was their mother's name, Susanna Wesley, the profound impact she had on their lives, if it wasn't for her, they call her the mother of Methodism, because if it hadn't been for her laying the foundation in her children's lives, then we wouldn't be Methodists. We'd be something else today. And of course, when John Wesley was traveling the world, it was in the 1700s, so they didn't have email or text or phones or Zoom or whatever they come out with next. So he had to, he used letters. And whenever he wanted to chat with his mom, he would just write her a letter. And Susanna viewed motherhood as a role from God. And she had 10 surviving children. And her husband was a priest, so he was always on the road, and so she was the one who stayed home to take care of the kids. And she made time for each of them and homeschooled them. And to give you an example of how she approached things, which is very methodically, and I'm sure that inspired John. You get it? Methodically, Methodism. Because for example, in a letter she wrote to her husband, she wrote while he was away, she wrote, on Monday I talked with Molly, on Tuesday Hetty, Wednesday with Nancy, Thursday with Jackie. That's what the family called John, was Jackie. Friday with Patty, Saturday with Charles, the prolific hymn writer. And with Emily and Suki together on Sunday. And during that one-on-one time that she spent with them, she mentored each child on what it means to live as a follower of Jesus. And John's time with his mom, stayed with him and impacted him throughout his life. And when he was five, he was dramatically saved from a fire in the family's home as it burned. And from that time on, Susanna sometimes called her Jackie, a brand plucked from the burning, referring to Zechariah 3, verse 2. And then that's when John Wesley realized that God saved him for a purpose. Well, as he went into ministry and was away from her, the bond continued, and he wrote letters to her asking for advice. And when he was a student at Oxford, he corresponded with her about books he ought to be reading. And when he was a newly ordained pastor, deciding if he should serve as a missionary to Georgia, in what we now call the U.S., he sought advice from many people, but historians believe it was his mother and her counsel that decided him to go, made it the deciding factor for him to go. And lay servants, we wouldn't have lay servants if it wasn't for her. It was her advice to him that caused him to realize that it was okay. She said, "Take care of what you do with respect to that young man, for he is as surely called of God to preach as you are." And so Wesley, who was methodical and was a stickler for all the rules and roles, he loosened up and allowed lay servants because of his mom. And there's no written evidence of this, but there are some that believe one reason why Wesley was willing to let women have leadership positions in the early church was because of his mom, because his mother would hold sermons. She would preach in the yard, and hundreds of people would come over to listen to her. And so I want to share one other thing here, that as he was traveling, you know, he would, in many of the letters, he would ask her to pray for him. For example, toward the conclusion of the letter from Holland that he wrote her, he said, "Dear mother, pray earnestly for me, that all things may work together for my good, and that by all God would build me in the faith which is in Christ Jesus." And, you know, so she was his prayer warrior. And, you know, I hope if you take anything away from this history lesson, is that her conscious decision to pass on her faith to her children impacted John's life and Charles's life, as I'm sure the other siblings as well. But her decision, really think about it, impacted all of us. And so, for us all, not just the mothers and mother figures here, but for us all, to set an example, to make time. Can you imagine having 10 kids and making time each day for each, to spend time with each of them alone? Can you imagine that? But she did. And she taught them who Jesus was. Taught them what a life in Christ is. And those influences impacted him for the rest of his life. And impacts us today. So I share that with the hopes that we all realize that we have the opportunity to have an impact. And then also, take time, hopefully you'll take time today, if you haven't already, to not only just remember your mothers, but also remember all the mother figures in your life, from your grandmother, aunt, neighbor, Sunday school teacher, you name it. You know, remember those figures in your life who led you to where you are today. Today is a day to honor all of them. And I want to share one more thing. And this was a prayer of Susanna Wesley. And I would just invite you now to join me, and we'll pray this prayer. If you'll bow your heads. You, O Lord, have called us to watch and pray. Therefore, whatever may be the sin against which we pray, make us careful to watch against it, and so have reason to expect that our prayers will be answered. In order to perform this duty aright, grant us grace to preserve a sober and equal temper, and sincerity to pray for your assistance. Amen. And now, we will hear from our praise team.
Good morning. If you're able, please stand and join us. I know the last few weeks we've been celebrating the resurrection a lot in song. We're going to continue that today, but we're going to sing not just about Jesus' resurrection. We're going to sing about the privilege we all have of being resurrected someday.
Some glad morning when this life is o'er, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, shadows of this life have gone, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars blown, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away.
In the morning
when I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by,
it'll be great to sing that with everyone someday.
You are here, moving in our midst. Oh, You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, mending every heart. I worship you. I worship you. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 Even when I don't see it, you're worship. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. 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 That is who you are.
Amen. Take some time and say hello to your neighbor.
All right, I should have a video from a friend of ours.
You know, there are a lot of people who need a lot of help. And I think a lot of times we see all this hopelessness. We see all this need in the world, and it just seems so big that we end up doing nothing. We're like, I could never put a dent in that, so I'm just not going to do anything. Well, I think that, yeah, there is a lot of need, and I think it is up to us to do something about it. But you don't have to help everyone. God just wants you to help someone. If you see someone in need and it's in your power to help them, help them. It doesn't mean you have to take on all the world's problems yourself. But if we all started helping, you know, just where we can, it's hard to even imagine how big of an impact we could have on the world. Helping those in need doesn't mean you have to solve all the world's problems. Just do what you can. And man, talk is cheap. If all you're doing is talking about it, you're not doing anything. Help those in need.
The kids and the big kids. What praises do you have this morning? Yeah. If you didn't hear her, the baseball team won the sectional championships.
I just want to, I praise that I have my whole family here, or at least the majority of them here today.
Any other? Oh, go ahead.
I recently found out that I made the junior cheerleading team for the Cincinnati Bengals recently.
That's wonderful. Any other? We went down here.
We have 19 kids going to state for track.
Kate is at Beach Week at Myrtle Beach this week, and which is, I just want to say, she went with Baptist Campus Ministries this week, this group that she found at college, and I just want to be so grateful that opportunities like that exist. They have worshiped together every morning and every night. They're doing a service project this afternoon, and I'm just so grateful that there are opportunities in this world with like-minded Christians to go and enjoy this world that God has made and be Christ-like in the moments.
Thank you. Any other praises?
This is a joy for our entire family, I think. Our grandson, Brady, graduated from WVU yesterday and graduated with honors. I guess it was day before yesterday. Graduated with honors, and he wasn't real sure he was going to graduate at all.
Good.
Lexi turned 21 on Tuesday.
Gotcha. Any other birthdays we're missing? Any other praises? Randy has one. Do you have your microphone?
I have a prayer concern.
Oh, okay.
Julie Yonley, who is our office manager at the funeral home. She has a grandson who was born about 4 weeks ago to Shay. And the baby was born in Camden Clark. And the next day, the baby was life flighted to Ruby. And then the diagnosis right now is neonatal diabetes, which is very rare and very uncommon. And Julie said there were 106 cases in the whole United States. It's probably a genetic defect. They don't know yet. But the baby was 4 pounds and 3 ounces when he was born. He has now lost weight. He's had a blood transfusion, genetic testing, and everything. And they still have no concrete answers on how to treat the baby. So real, real concern for everyone. So keep baby Rhett in your prayers.
Definitely will. Jim has one.
Yeah, Calvin Stackpole, he had a hernia operation, and I think he's doing pretty good, but keep him in your prayers. He's at Marietta Memorial.
Will do. Do we have another hand? Any other prayer concerns? Judy? Nyla. Nyla Gowdy is in the hospital. Any other prayer concerns? Yep. Jim's got another one.
Terry Kozart, we used to work with up the plant. I guess he got burnt real bad. I just heard about this morning, so I guess he's West Penn, I guess.
Any others we need to remember? Well, if there's not, then let us take our prayer concerns and our praises to the Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift up and place in your care our prayer concerns, spoken out loud, as well as the ones that are in our hearts, Lord. You know our need. Lord, watch over those who are in need. Bring them the peace and the comfort, the strength they need, Lord. Lord, help them to trust in you. Lord, watch over our church and our country. Guide and direct our decisions. Lord, help us, convict us to make the right choices. And Lord, we praise you for your many blessings. And Lord, we know we often fall short. But Lord, we praise you and honor you for your unconditional love. And we thank you, Lord, for always being there to pick us up. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now I invite you to stand if you're able, and we will recite the Apostles' Creed on 881. It's also on the screen. I believe in God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And now we will sing the doxology on page 95. Oh. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. Before this morning, we'll be in John chapter 14, verses 15 through 21. And before we begin our reading this morning, I would invite you to join me, and we'll begin with a word of prayer. Father, anoint us all with your Holy Spirit, that as we read your word, that it inspire us and remind us of its transformative power. And may we recognize and listen to these words and remember that it is our duty to share your love with those around us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Beginning in verse 15, if you love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. A little while longer, and the world will see me no more. But you will see me, because I live, you will live also. At that day, you will know that I am in my Father, in you and me, and I in you. He who has my commandments and keeps them, it is he who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. This is the word of the Lord. Amen. I will not leave you orphans. Those words speak directly, if we're honest with ourselves, to some of our greatest fears and challenges. Feeling abandoned. Feeling lonely. And feeling vulnerable. These words remind us that we are not destined to walk this earth without direction. We do not stand alone. To be sure, there are going to be moments, life's transitions, life's changes, and life's tragedies that can leave us feeling like we're orphaned. What will I do now? Where do I go? What happens next? Who will love, nurture, and guide me? What will become of me? These are the questions that probably ran through the heads and the hearts of the disciples. And when we are dealing with changes, if we're honest, these questions are running through our heads as well. In John chapter 14, we are at the Last Supper. The disciples have been fed and feet have been washed. It is nighttime. And then that night gets darker because Jesus announces he is leaving. And I would imagine the disciples felt that their world was falling in around them. I will not leave you orphans. Anyone who has ever loved has lost as well. That's just life. And anyone who has ever loved and has lost, which we all have at some point in our lives, we know the orphans' questions. We fear becoming orphaned. That fear points to something deep in us, that we aren't enough. We aren't really strong enough to handle things alone. An example I used recently, you know, a little kid who's bound and determined to go venture off by themselves and explore, eventually realizes it's a scary place out there. And when they lose sight of something familiar, what do? They scream. They look for their parent or guardian's hand. They look for them to pick them up and watch over them and reassure them that it's okay. And if we're honest with ourselves, we are like that. You know, if we're honest with ourselves, we have that fear of being alone. I shared it at Friendly an example for me was one of the biggest fears I had about coming here was the fear of all those things that were familiar to me, the people. It was not going to be the same anymore. The people, the friends, those close to me that I've had come to rely on for advice and prayers and, you know, for fun, the friends, I wasn't going to have that anymore. And no matter what you say, no matter how much you mean it, things are, when you move on, things are never going to quite ever be the same again. Distance will eventually play a role. However, you know, I found comfort in God. I mean, I'm not saying that those moments of feeling alone didn't creep up when I came here. Of course they did. It took me a long while to get used to it. And to be honest, I mean, sometimes those feelings still creep up. But but it is a reminder of the fact that, you know, we weren't intended to be we weren't intended or created to be self-sufficient. We were never intended to stand alone as individuals. We were created to love and be loved. We were created to have people in our lives to be close to. And when we don't have Jesus, life is confusing and insecure. You know, we need help, and when we don't know where to go, we make bad choices. And we find help in things and people who do more harm than good. That God offers us his gift of salvation to rescue us from being orphans. He brought us into his home, and though we continue to sin and act like orphans sometimes, he continues to love us. We were adopted, and as a result, we get to share the Father's heart. And it's up to us to glorify God by loving the orphans around us and to show them the true Father. Now, and back to my example for a moment. You know, God has revealed that to me time and time again, that I'm not alone. You know, he is, you know, my strength when I'm weak, or want to throw up my hands and or hit my, you know, pound my hand down because I'm frustrated about something. You know, he is there to pick me up and remind me it's going to be okay. And, you know, when seasons change in our lives, God will bring new people into our lives to have those relationships with that we need. And that's what he's done for me. And, you know, it doesn't mean you forget where you were. Those people that I was close to, those friends and folks I was close to, you know, we may not talk as much as we used to, but when we do, or when I get to go and see them, it just makes the time together even more special. And I will not leave you orphans. That is the promise. And regardless of the circumstances of our lives, no matter the storms, no matter what the change, whatever change is coming our way, we have never been and will never be orphaned by God. And I couldn't help but think yesterday about how, in some ways, this was a Mother's Day message. Because I couldn't help but think about John Wesley. You know, here was someone who was traveling the world doing God's work, and he was relying on God for his strength, but he also needed that love and, I'm sure, reassurance, and needed that confidence of his mom. And so God, you know, God had placed her there to help him. And I've read lots of his journal entries. I mean, he was a prolific writer. He wrote down literally almost everything he ever did. And he was also honest in these journals, and he wrote about his struggles. He wrote about his successes. He wrote about those times in his life where he was at a crossroads and didn't know what to do. But there was a reoccurring theme in these when his mother was still alive, and that he relied on her for advice, and she never left him. And you know, in our lives, I hope today that you'll take time again to recognize those people in your life, mothers and mother figures, those saints who have passed or who are maybe still here. Take time to remember them. You know, they're what I call a human angel. You know, someone God's placed in our path to help us and be there for us. You know, John was able to, you know, he would not have done what he did if it hadn't been for her. I don't believe he would have, because she was the one who taught him, and when he needed that reassurance and needed that guidance, she was there for him. And you know, God does not ever leave us orphaned. He's never abandoned us. And so I just encourage you today to also do not abandon yourself or others. Love like Jesus loves. He's with us always. And you know, the best way to honor those saints in your life are to carry on what they did in your life. So then it just continues to pass on. You know, I say often in funerals that, and I mean this, that when we lose somebody who was close to us, there is going to be a hole, a part of us missing. However, when we take time to remember them and honor them and carry on what they did, they're still with us. Maybe not in the physical sense, but they're with us and there for us. I will not leave you orphans. That is the promise. That is the promise that God offers to all of us who accept his gift of salvation. He's there to rescue us. We're not alone. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, during those moments in our lives when we feel like we're alone, or we feel like the world is crashing in around us, the walls are falling in. Lord, help us to remember that we're not alone, that you're there to give us strength. You're there to give us the guidance we need. And Lord, help us to remember that we have those who are around us who are there to be your light here on this earth. You've placed us all together for a reason. Help us to remember that. And Lord, we live in a hurting world. Lord, help us as we encounter others who are feeling orphaned. Enable us, Lord, to recognize their need and to help them. Help us to carry your light and make it shine brightly. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. I wanted, and I, the message I just shared was also meant for the graduates, because you're about to embark on a new chapter in your life, and things are going to be changing for you rather quickly. The summer is going to go by fast. And some of you are going to be in unfamiliar territory. And just remember, you're not alone. You have God with you. And God will place new people in your path who are going to be there to offer guidance. When you need a laugh, they'll be there to give you a laugh. They'll be there to support you. God's going to put new people in your path. Doesn't mean you're going to forget or lose the ones you're leaving behind. No, your family is going to be growing. Your friends are going to be growing, the amount of people you have in your life. And know that the Lord is going to be with you, as well as your church family, your youth group leaders. They're going to be with you every step of the way. And while you may not always see those familiar faces all the time like you are now, it just got to make the time that you are with them even more special when you do get to see them. But just remember, the Lord is with you. And I wanted to share in Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. And I'm also going to share here from Jeremiah 29, 11 through 13. In this particular scripture, it is very important to me. This is a favorite one of my, I call her my second mom. For 30 some years, she was in charge of, a part of, and then eventually in charge of Marion County Project graduation. It was an event that was held on graduation night in Marion County, and it was a safe place for kids to gather and fellowship and party, but it was safe. And it's hard to tell how many thousands of lives were possibly saved over the years from being impacted by making bad choices on graduation night. It was a safe place, and it was But she always made sure they left at the end of the night. Everybody got a prize. And when I'm talking about prizes, we're talking TVs and Apple Watches. I mean, and there were scholarships and different things available, you know, that were given away as prizes. But she always made sure each of those kids left with a Bible. And she would always read Jeremiah 29, 11 through 13. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you. And you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all your heart. So just remember, always, to carry the Lord with you. And as long as you keep him close, you're never going to be alone. He's going to be there to be your strength when you're frustrated about a test you have coming up, or you're getting behind on your homework. That's not going to happen, though, is it? That never happens. But he's going to be there and be your strength when you need it. And now... We will.
Is that all right for me to
borrow? Today is a day to not only honor mothers and mother figures, but today we're also honoring our graduates. And what I'm going to do now is call them up individually, and then we have a gift as well as a Bible for you to carry with you. And remember that this is going to be armor for you. When you need ever need guidance, just pick this up. And also, when you pick this up, remember that you have people back here who love you and are here for you. So with that being said, can I have Katie Doig come forward? And then when they come up, I don't mean to put you on the spot, but when you come up, if you'll let everybody know what your plans are.
My plan is to go to Fairmont for a business degree. That's it.
Thank you. And then if you could just stand over here. Jordan Ebert.
I'm going to WVUP for business.
Thank you. Jesse Griffith. And your dad's taking a video, so watch him. And then if you could let everybody know.
I'm going to WVU for either chemical engineering or aerospace. Not real sure yet.
Thank you. Jaden Helmick. And your dad's doing the same thing.
I plan to attend Glenville State University to study computer science and play baseball.
Mason Nichols. Thank you.
I'll be attending West Virginia Wesleyan, where I'll major in biology and also play golf.
Thank you. And then, if we could also have Caitlin Northcraft come up. If you'll let everybody know what your plans are.
I will be going to the U.S. Navy.
Thank you. And then I now would like to invite Reverend Colleen Griffith to come forward. And I invited Reverend Colleen to offer a blessing over our graduates. And I thought Zoe was coming with her. and then also, I wanted to just invite everybody who wants to come forward. I know we've got a large group here, but anybody who wants to come forward, and we'll pray over them.
Don't be shy. Let us pray. Almighty God, we just thank you and we praise you so much for these, your wonderful sons and daughters, Jesse's friends since they were babies. And I just thank you, God, for your blessing in their life, for their parents, for their church, for the way that you have worked in them. Be with Annie and Jordan. Be with Jesse and Jaden. Be with Mason and Caitlin. And we just pray, Lord, that you will guide them and direct them to know that they have you as their hope and their future, that they will always be in your love, that you will guide them always, that your spirit will surround them, and that your presence will always be with them. Anytime that they're feeling lonely or homesick, we just pray that you will help them to close their eyes and feel your love surrounding them and our prayers lifting them up. We just thank you, Heavenly Father, for the way that you have worked through their families and through this church family to guide them all these years. And we just know that those lessons will carry them through into their adult lives. And we praise you in Jesus' name, and all of God's people said, amen.
And now we will have our closing song.
This is for all the graduates. God loves you, and I love you all too.
As a child, I did childish things. My life was church and all it brings. I always hear the old folks sing, he's never failed me yet. I heard this phrase and I trusted so that one day I would come to know the truth in which these words do hold. He's never failed me yet. There all the while, my soul was not at rest, but I live to tell that I made it through. So instead of singing about the blues, I bring you news to encourage you. God never failed me yet. When the clouds and the valleys come, set your eyes on the risen sun. the Lord aloud. Singing out songs and shouting wow, God never failed me yet. God is not like him who lies, nor like the son of him who dies. Still will always be alive, it never will be dead. So cry before yourself and see yes, baby, baby. Never failed me yet.
He's never failed me yet. He's never failed me yet.
He's never failed me yet. I'm grateful for those simple words that I so often overheard. But many memories drift like birds, some still I can't forget. They come back ringing right on time, like bells so heavenly they chime. That old time phrase, now mine, all mine, these never fail me. There's no way we're going to sit while singing Standing on the Promises. So if you're able, please stand.
On the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior, standing, standing. Standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of Christ the Lord, bound to Him eternally by love's strong cord, overwhelming daily with the Spirit's sword. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I cannot fall. Listening every moment to the Spirit's call. Resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing. On the promises of God.
To to our graduates, the future is all yours now. Go for it. And may the Lord bless your steps and watch over you always. May we all go in peace. Amen.